for being here. I really appreciate it. If you're watching on YouTube, don't forget to leave a like. It really helps out the channel. And if you are live with me on Twitch, there's over 200 of you, so that's pretty cool. Thank you so much for hanging out today. So now we are moving on to another pretty hyped deck from the new set. It's good old Malamar, but with new compadres. So we have Malamar with its psychic recharge ability, where you get to attach a psychic energy card from your discard pile to one of your benched Pokemon. And then we have a wide array of attackers in order to use that ability. The most notable and newest one is Giratina. 130 HP, a pretty good number to have, especially because it's not psychic weak. And then the ability Distortion Door. Once during your turn before your attack, if this Pokemon is in your discard pile, you may put it onto your bench. If you do, you put one damage counter on two of your opponent's benched Pokemon. So it has a self included Rescue Stretcher ability. Yeah, self-included Rescue Stretcher ability, and you also get to deal a little bit of damage to something on your opponent's benched Pokemon. Now, Giratina in combination with the new Spell Tag tool card, where when the psychic Pokemon this card is attached to is knocked out by damage from an opponent's attack, put 4 damage counters on your opponent's Pokemon in any way you like. So that right there is just a little bit of extra damage, and then in combination with the 130 damage you're dealing naturally with your Shadow Impact attack, the damage definitely starts to pile up. Yeah, and then put 4 damage counters on one of your Pokemon is the drawback of the attack, but you can start placing them on the Malamar. However, in the mirror matches, the placement of those damage counters is going to be very, very crucial. We also have the Onix, the basic Onix with the Land Crush attack, dealing 120 damage and just doing that for 4 energy. It's the only non-GX attacker, basic attacker, that can one-hit KO a Zorg, which, as many of you know, is Malamar's biggest headache. And so Onix is there as a tech card in order to deal with Zorg. Then we have one Shining Arceus used in the Japanese tournament winning list. Its ability Fabled Defense. As long as this Pokemon is your active Pokemon, prevent all damage done to your bench Pokemon by your opponent's attacks. And finally, we have Ultimate Arrow, which deals 30 damage to each of your opponent's Pokemon for 4 energy. Now, this goes in tandem with Tapu Koko, 110 HP, and then the attack Flying Flip. You deal 20 damage to each of your opponent's Pokemon. So we have a really solid, like, powerful attack in Shadow Impact, but we also have the spreading potential. And the cube, thank you so much for the follow. Outside of that, we have the Lunala Prism. Psystorm is a really good attack, and then Full Moon Star allows you to get energy into play even if you don't have Malamars out as much. And then we have one Across My GX for its pretty powerful Prismatic Burst attack, which can one KO pretty much anything. And then Black Ray GX is another way to spread damage around. And finally, we have the single Tapu Lele for consistency's purposes. Supporters wise, we have a wide variety of supporters. We have the 4 Cynthia, we have triple Guzma, triple Lily, and then we have 2 Tatan Lysas, 2 Team Reporters to get those psychics into a discard pile, and then the single new Full Art Judge. Yeah, this card is from the new set. We hadn't had a Full Art Judge before, so that's pretty cool. And then items wise, we have the 4 spell decks that I showcased earlier in the video. 4 Mysterious Treasure, triple Nest Ball, double Rescue Stretcher, double Drawl, and a single Shrine of Punishment. 10 basic psychics, 2 DCs, and let's jump into the ladder to keep trying out this new deck. No psychic Lele indeed, guys. Yeah, no psychic Lele indeed. Simply because like, the games come down to you just spread a little and then maybe finish things off with Giratina. If we see that the spreading aspect of the deck ends up being super, super powerful, then you could include it. But I'm basing this off of the list that won a 1200 person tournament, and so it's hard to question such a list, right? Gonza Wolf, my name is not Pedro, it's Pablo. I would like to go first. That's the second time I've been called a different name today, today's stream. Team Reporter over Sightseer. I mean, see Vortex. Okay, so Sightseer is really good in Blacephalon because you're playing 16 basic fire energies, right? So you're gonna have usually one or two in your hand, right? But this deck only plays 10 basic psychic energy. So the chance of you having a psychic energy in your hand is less. Yeah, it's lower, rather. So that's why Team Report is better, because if you don't have a psychic and you have the Sightseer, then you're definitely not getting a psychic in the discard pile. But if you have no psychic and a new Team Reporter into a psychic, then you can put it into the discard pile. Yeah, so it's pros and cons, right? Both cards are good. Sightseer is better in some decks, Team Reporter is better in other decks. Yeah. This is a 60-60 list from the Japanese tournament. I believe it is. Yeah, I believe it is. So hopefully that was a good enough explanation as to why. Ooh, and we're up against a Zoroark deck already. That's pretty cool. Do I want another Coco? I think so. Dalton. Thank you so much for the bit. Let's just Lily for 5 here. We get a psychic to potentially attach or discard. Tininchi indeed. Okay, I definitely want an Ultra Ball. Right, I definitely want an Ultra Ball. I feel like Lunala Prism is not gonna be good in this match. And then discarding the psychic or attaching the psychic basically accomplishes the same thing for next turn, so I'll do that. And we're hoping the Onyx will allow us to hunt down Zoroark, and then we'll pass. Yeah. Still, it's good if you discard Giratina, which you can do just as well with Team Reporter, right? So, like I said, both are good cards, right? I'm not saying this is the end-all be-all, but this list did win a 1,200-person tournament, so there's merit to it, right? Did I make a Zoroark deck? No, I did not. No Morty? No, no Morty either. Okay. The issue is I don't really have anything to pressure the Rockruff next turn. Right? I don't have anything to pressure the Rockruff so that I force the Zoroark active. We see a Lily. Rig disproves the lack of Morty. I'm not even sure what Morty does, if I'm honest. I don't remember what Morty does. To win a 1200 Masters tournament, that deck needs to be really good, right? So it's hard to question like how to improve a deck that just won a 1200 player tournament. Okay, so Great Ball finds him a Lele, that's fine. Better than him finding a Rockruff. And then we see that pass. Okay, so the Shining Arceus. Not very impressive. TV Reporter would need to get me two Psychics and a Giratina exactly to be good in this spot, so probably not. That's horrible. That is actually a horrible hand. That is actually a horrible hand. I think I'm just gonna... Jeez. Maybe they'll keep Oneness Pull. And I guess I'm spreading this turn. What a horrible hand we seem to get into. Indeed, Max Rock. Indeed. Okay, so we're gonna Flying Flip. Get some damage on the board. I keep the Shrine for now. What are the theme decks for this set? I have no idea. Ultra Ball. I mean, if you get Lycanroc, do you KO the Coco or do you go after Malamar? Goes for Zoroark, it's fine. In some universe, my opponent whiffs the DC and that makes us very happy. Although he does have Lele into Malo, although he just traded. Trades a stadium though, so that's good. So holding the Shrine was really good. Holding the Shrine was really good. Does this list run Baby Lele? No, it does not. Okay, so there's a TCE, so it looks like my opponent will end up retreating the Rockruff, which honestly makes me happy. Oh wow, the Entei theme deck has Malo, Sightseer, Guzma, Lily, and the new baby Naganadel? Wow, that's actually insane. Okay, in some universe, I could top deck to KO with Onyx onto that Zork. Oh no, he has a weakness policy, never mind. So I can't KO the Zork. Okay. So, not looking good here. Not looking good. That's a good top deck, however. That is definitely a good top deck. I think I go Giratina. I mean, I could go Necrozma. Necrozma actually doesn't sound like a bad idea. The Shrine. Would I Shrine? No, I wouldn't Shrine. I think I'm gonna go Giratina. Just pressure the active. I mean, I need a Malamar and a Psychic. I need a Malamar and a Psychic, which I got. I also got the KO with Onyx, but the weakness policy, darn. Okay, it's fine though. It's fine. We are fine. Because we can use Onyx for a Benzork if we need to. Right? And then this is the beauty of Giratina, that if my opponent tries to target down Malamar, then Giratina stays alive, right? And it just keeps applying pressure. And then the 4 damage counters will probably be placed onto a Malamar. Because my opponent, like, he will always be able to deal 90 damage, so even if I have 10 HP left, it's not a big deal. And then Shadow Impact onto the Zork, the 4 damage on the Malamar. And the Shrine does a little bit of work. Okay. Raikou theme deck has two baby Naganadel and one Substrika. Wow. And what supporters does it have? The Entei theme deck actually sounds like a really good theme deck. For all the staples. If it has Guzma, that's pretty broken. That should bring the price of Guzma down. So this list only plays Run Shrine. Is that enough, Flame Axel? I don't know. This is the first game I'm playing with a list. Yeah? But one Shrine was enough to win a 1200 person tournament, so apparently so. Okay, so please KO me and don't Acerola. Like, please retreat. That would be best case scenario. My opponent decides to retreat the Zork to save it, and then decides to attack with this other Zork if he can't Acerola. That would be really sweet. Guzma is in the Entei deck. Why on Malamar and not on Onyx? Because I want to keep Onyx as healthy as possible. Right? If I put them on Onyx, then a Claw Slash knocks out the Onyx. Whereas, without the damage, the Claw Slash doesn't kill the Onyx. And, like, what's the difference between Malamar having 90, 50, or 10 HP? Literally no difference. Right? Literally no difference whatsoever. Hello, Sir Bandage. How are you doing? It's been a while for sure. Why not the 4 damage counters on Tina? It has to be on the bench? Oh yeah, they could have been placed on the Giratina. Yeah, I guess 4 on the Giratina would have been the best call. I don't think it matters, guys. Like, just think about the mats. It literally doesn't matter. It literally does not matter. I probably should have saved that Nest Ball. Probably should have saved that Nest Ball. Yeah, I should have saved that Nest Ball. That was silly. I could GX this turn, but then he comes up and GXs me. Oh, I should not have played that Nest Ball. That was me playing an automatic pilot. That was me playing an automatic pilot.
I really should not have played that nest ball.
Okay.
Oh, now I don't place them. Now I should not have placed them on the Giratina. Oops. Okay, the Mysterious Treasure helps, I guess. Is this a Japanese list? Yes, it is. How many Giratina does this list run? Two. Yeah, the four damage counters now on the Giratina were a bad idea. Well, not terribly bad. Double Torque. Okay, so my opponent goes down to three prizes. We can use Necrozman this turn to get a KO on the Lycanroc, which is pretty good. Right, as long as we find a Psychic, we can't get the knockout on the Lycanroc. And then afterwards, we just need to find something to KO Zoroark or KO Lele. Onyx top deck. I can't top deck Onyx, it's in the discard pile already. Could top deck Stretcher. Ooh, but he's gonna have to Dangerous Roll. Okay, that's even better. That is actually even better, because now my Necrozma definitely survives. So I could even go GX attack the Lycanroc. No, I don't think I would do that though. I only have three Guzmas. I think Guzma is how I'm going to win this game. So I'm going to search for Necrozma and then I'm going to Cynthia. I need one Psychic Energy or a Malamar or a Mysterious Treasure or an Ultra Ball. Any of those. And I get them all. Well, not all, but... And I have the Rescue Stretcher for the Onyx. So we have the game pretty much won. Right? We have Guzma, Rescue Stretcher for the Onyx. Or we just have the Guzma to KO anything with Necrozma as well. Which is pretty good. Boop. And as long as we don't get judged, we have the game in our hands. Right? We can use Onyx. If I can finish it with Onyx, I will. Yeah, and spell tags, that's the first spell tag we've seen. If I can finish it with Onyx, I will. Yeah? If I can't, then... Oh well. Yeah, KOing with Onyx would be pretty cool. First land crush on PTCGL. I don't think my opponent will be able to get a knockout here. Unless he grabs Guzma off of that. Okay, so he might knock out the active. That would be awesome. Because that means a choice ban on the active. Right? That means a choice ban on the active. That means not a... not a weakness policy, which means we get a knockout. Nice psychedelic guard on the Onyx. It's sleeping, right? It looks like it's sleeping underground. So, trade. DC choice band. Awesome. So we have the Onyx KO on the poor Zoroark. I hope my opponent lets me do it though. It takes me quite a few clicks to accomplish it, so my opponent might not let me do it. My opponent might concede beforehand. Okay. So Onyx, here we go. My opponent says we'll play. Please don't concede, friend. Please do not concede. Let me land crush you. I don't know why I'm singing. Okay. Just don't misclick Pablo and you should be good. Awesome. Land crush for the win. Onyx MVP. I mean, having the option is really nice, right? We would have been able to knock out with Necrozma again, though. So that was just fancy play. But having the option, like, my opponent was forced, like, he was so afraid of the Onyx that he targeted that down over a Malamar.
Yeah, which there's a lot of value to that. Yeah, if Onyx's only purpose is to save a Malamar, that's worth it. Yeah, in the long run. Yeah, because it's much easier to recover an Onyx than a Malamar. Right? And Dalton, you gave me a bit earlier. I don't know if I said thank you, but thank you. Appreciate it. And props to my opponent, indeed. Props to my opponent, indeed. Praise be to the Rock Snake. Okay, we're up against Jeremy, who always uses cool, innovative decks. We have a pretty good start. Starting Coco is always good. Like, starting Coco is the ideal start for this deck. So it's really lucky to start it with only two and having, like, four Inkes, the Onyx, the Giratinas, everything else. Oh, but we're up against a spread deck. Okay, so right off the bat, not ideal. Yeah, right off the bat, not ideal. You can see an Energy Lodo with a Darkness attached and a Copycat. Interesting. Okay. Arceus time. Oh, Arceus, that's right. Arceus is gonna be the MVP here because it spreads and it prevents spreading from your opponent. Arceus' bench protection, oh my gosh, it's gonna be super valuable, except, yikes, that's a really sad hand. I think I just flying flip here? I mean, I shouldn't be threatened, right? Shouldn't be threatened. This is bad though. He's maybe playing spread Weavile. Probably, yeah. That would explain the dark energy. He might be playing Hoopa as well. Might be playing Hoopa. Are we really gonna go into a flying flip battle here? I mean, he only gets 20 damage, which is nice. He only gets 20 damage. Okay, that's a nice Tate and Liza top deck. Shining Arceus. I mean, I think I just go for that. Right, to start getting it as ready as quickly, I mean, to start getting it ready as quickly as possible. The Ultra Ball I might need to save for a Lele. Jeez. Yeah, I'm gonna have to save the Ultra Ball for Lele. Which is not terrible because I could start using Arceus next turn and just prevent the spread. Hunchcrow, he might be playing Hunchcrow as well. That's correct. Lots of possibilities, right? Lots of possibilities. Okay, so there's a Weavile. I think I'll get rid of the Lunala Prism Star. And I'll attach this spell deck to a Malamar just in case it like gets that. Or maybe to Lele actually. I'll attach this spell deck to the Lele. I'll attach this spell deck to Lele. I'll save the Judge for later. So I'm choosing Lele over Cynthia. Both net me 6 cards, but Cynthia is better later. I'll spell deck the Lele and then please give me a Psychic. There we go. Perfect. Perfect, perfect. So now we get to spread 30 and protect our bench, which is awesome. Right? Which is really awesome. Shining Arceus just says, no thank you to this deck. Ultimate Arrow. There's a Weavile. There's a Shrine, that's fine. Rule of Evil, 60 damage to each weapon that has an ability. That's a 2-hit KO onto the Shining Arceus. Oh, that's a bad Kuzma for us. That's a really bad Kuzma for us. Uh-oh. Well, that's not good. We're gonna lose almost 3 prizes next turn. Uh-oh. Well, not almost 3 prizes. Definitely, we're losing 3 prizes. Oh, jeez. Okay, so what does spell tag say? Damage from Okay, so we would be able to place 8 damage counters back. Well, not 8, only 6 so far. 130, 140, yeah. Only 6 so far, it's not terrible. I mean, no point in attaching to anything else, right? So I'll just pass. Does the problem mean to prevent the entire spread of 20 damage on each Pokemon? Yes, it does. Good play by opponent indeed. Do you think there will be a Sycamore Discard Draw 7 reprint soon? I don't think so. I don't think so. Okay, so yeah. We have 8 damage counters to place. No, we have 6. 4 damage counters to place. So I place them on the Weavile. And I knock it out with spread. Right? Because then he spreads. Okay, so that's KO. Then he spreads with his Coco. And then knocks out my Lele. And I get another 4 damage counters. Right? Why not energy to Lele? Because I'm going to lose the Lele. For sure. I'm 100% going to lose the Lele. Do I get back the Shining Arceus? Or the Inkay? I guess the Arceus. Because I still have Inkays. It's like I don't need any more energy in the discard pile. I value having energy in my hand. So I don't need to attach energy. Just because the rules of Pokemon say that I can attach an energy per turn doesn't mean I need to every single turn. He may not even spread next turn. I mean, that's fine. It's less damage on us, which is good. Spread is his only move though. Like another spread and we get another 2 prizes. He could move damage around though. He has 200 damage, that's 2 prizes. Ugh. Yeah, he probably won't spread. He's gonna look for a counter energy. No, he can't counter energy. He can't magical swap because he's winning. He actually can't magical swap because he's winning. Yeah, he can't use counter energy. There's another Coco. I have not done that deck yet. That might be the next deck. Ooh, Professor Kukui. Yes, he spreads. Okay, that's good, right? That's good. Sure, he gets a knockout, but we get 4 damage counters. I guess it's not that great. So, who gets the damage counters? I mean, I just take the 2 knockouts, right? I can't attack with anything that's not spread next turn. So this guy is gone anyways, this guy is gone anyways. So I don't think these 4 damage counters actually matter at all. Yeah, I don't think they matter at all. Sure, on the Coco, I guess. Okay. So, discard the Giratina, grab an Inkay. I mean, the extra damage from Giratina also doesn't matter. Attached to the Shining Arceus. Well, it might. No, it probably won't. It might eventually. But I don't want to have a target that he can bring up like we did last time. But I have the Lily now. I mean, the Tatum Lights, I guess, so. It would be okay. Because I can just switch. And I have the Kuzma now. Okay. Flying Flip. Am I playing with Alola next today? Yes, I am, Jeremy. Yes, I am. Like, I can't do all of the decks, yeah? And I'm trying to invest enough time to each deck to really get to know it. But yes, Alolan Exeggutor and Decidueye Alolan Ninetales is also coming soon, guys. Is there already its own deck or an add-on to Rayquaza? lovely Lexi. Is there already its own deck or an add-on to Rayquaza? Honestly, I don't know. I mean, it might be a one-off in Ray, and it might be its own deck. We'll have to try it out. Yeah, I am going to try out that deck eventually. Okay, Phantom, 60 HP. Jeez, that Phantom is actually very scary. 60, 30 more. I mean, I can spread again. Malamar. I do have a Judge as well, but I need to find it raw. Is Kuzma good? Probably. Kuzma might be good. Zorora sounds fun and expanded with eels. Maybe. Ray, maybe. Okay, and then he passes, so nothing he can do this turn. That's good. This guy is scary. So do I KO that guy? Or do I spread? It's just spreading is not that effective, right? And that's the only real threat. That's the only real threat. So I think I'm gonna... Okay. So I need to get the Giratina first, right? Just I want the damage counter on these two guys. So this is how I do it. I'll grab the Giratina this way. And then I'll power it up. And who gets the damage counters? That's the other question. Your first thought was Aurora with Solgaleo promo. It's like powering all of setting that up without Zoroark or something just seems like, why would you use that instead of Buzzle or instead of Zoroark? Yeah. Four damage to green and one and spread. How do I put four damage counters? That's not how the deck. That's not how Giratina works. Giratina's four damage placement is on your Pokemon, not theirs. So Distortion Door. And then we will Shadow Impact. And play the damage on the active, I feel. Or the other Giratina, actually. Yeah, so the four damage counter is on your Pokemon. And the ability places two, one on each bench. It doesn't just place four. That would be pretty broken. Okay, so the issue is that when we go down to one price, Mebun will have enough damage to rearrange and get two prizes, right? There's currently 160 damage. So I think I need to win by spreading, but I can't win by spreading. Doesn't grab the Lele in fear of a Guzma? I mean, KOing the Coco is also important potentially. If he goes Weavile, he doesn't win the game. He needs exactly Lele counter energy. Which feels like something he would be holding. Right? So how do we do this? If I retreat, attach... Spread with the 30 damage attack. KOing Coco means he would also need a Kuzma or a switch. So he needs three cards. Kuzma, Lele, counter energy. And he didn't ultra for the Lele. I'm just trying to think of what's better, spread or just attack. I think it's just attack here. I place more damage. I don't think it matters. Well, maybe it does actually. No, yeah. Now there's enough damage. There wasn't before for him to win. No, there. 160. No, there wasn't enough damage actually. Coco, Stretcher. Weavile. Rule of Evil. Doesn't KO Giratina. Doesn't KO this Giratina. Oh, does he have Kukui? Okay, there's a Lele. Does he have Kukui? Cynthia. Okay, so I think... Oh, this has free retreat. Oh my god.
He was holding the two stretchers, and the Weavile has free retreat.
Yeah, I should not have attacked with Giratina. I should have done the Guzma play and then just spread, kept spreading. Ugh. Oh well. I won't make him click 20 times. It was close though, it was close. That's a much more focused spread deck, right? A much more focused spread deck. The spell deck's damage was very underwhelming for sure. Outplayed? I mean, if you call keeping two stretchers in your hand and sending to a counter energy outplaying, then sure. It's outplaying. I probably should have used Arceus, yes. But he also needed very specific cards in order to get the return KO. Essentially double stretcher, right? Essentially double stretcher and hit the counter energy. But oh well. That's gonna be it for Malamar Giratina. It didn't feel as dominating as the other two decks. We need to move on to other decks. We need to give this deck a more solid run of games in order to really see its weaknesses and whatnot. We'll see what happens. So next deck will probably be the CDY Alolan Ninetales. It's a deck I'm really looking forward to playing. So don't go anywhere, guys. I will be right back in just a second. And if you're watching on YouTube, don't forget to leave a like. It really helps out the channel. So one second, guys. I will be right back.